Hi all, my name is Mujeeb Rahman. I'm from Kerala. So I am here to explain our success story of FOSS migration of Janayugom. This is the Janayugom newspaper. It is a newspaper in Kerala, around 1 lakh subscribers. And you can see the title of the newspaper. And at the top, they write as India's first newspaper that use completely FOSS technologies. This migration is done by Alpha 4 Technologies. I am co-founder of Alpha 4 Technologies. These four people are there. With the help of two other legends known as Hussein KH and Ashok Kumar. They were the main elements of the migration. They were started the program. Okay, let's introduce about Janayugom. It is a newspaper around 1 lakh readers. It is a political party newspaper. It is by Communist Party of India, Kerala State Committee newspaper, and it is established in 1947, having 14 bureaus across the Kerala. There is 14 districts in Kerala, and each district have its bureaus. And the headquarters is situated in Trivandrum. So I am explaining the outline of the project. There was 100 employees on Janayugom, including layout artists and accounting, etc. Also 100 plus system across the Kerala. So we did complete migration to Kubuntu based Janayugom Linux. This Janayugom Linux made by us just forked Kubuntu and added the necessary softwares to that. And from October 2 until today, they were using that Janayugom Linux for their newspaper production. That was a 3-month project. Before that, they were using Windows XP. You heard correct? Yeah, they were using some system, they were using Windows XP. Even you may be surprised. In Calicut, there is a press of Indian Express, the newspaper, Indian Express. They're still using Windows XP for printing. And Windows 7, this was the software, or some Windows 10 operating system was there. And they were using Adobe PageMaker 7 for their layouting purposes. In Kerala, most of the DTP owners using PageMaker now. The comedy is that PageMaker has stopped development in 2001. Then, image processing, they were using Photoshop 7. We know Photoshop has CC version now, but they were happy with Photoshop 7. So it was very easy for us to change to Gimp. Then they were using ASCII to Unicode conversion tool, because currently we get lot of Unicode data because mobile phone have Unicode typing. Everyone, we can see lot of Unicode data. So they have to convert it to the oldest technologies. So they're using Type It software for that and some other softwares. So this is the words of Rajaji Matthew. He was a former MLA in Kerala and now currently the editor of Janayugom. Naturally, we thought available proprietary software, Adobe InDesign. So the first switching was they planned to switch to InDesign, not to Scribus. So they somewhere they thought it could be, it may not be possible, and they were returning back. But after some years, some days, we updated the software like this. We switched their operating system to Janayugom GNU Linux, which is a Kubuntu 90.04 based operating system. And PageMaker is replaced by Scribus 1.5.6. Actually, it is a development version, not a stable one, but it is working more stable. In image processing, we are using Gimp 2.10 and Inkscape. ASCII to Unicode conversion tool, we created Janayugom Edit. It is created by us with the help of SMC's libraries. And in Janayugom Edit, we convert the ASCII characters to Unicode, not vice versa. In network, we're using SFTP, SSHFS, etc. in Dolphin. Some other softwares are KDE Plasma, LibreOffice, Firefox. There is some reimage package. This all, every softwares are included in the OS. So they have to install the OS. They will get all the softwares. And there are 75 systems to be installed. So we went to each bureau and installed the system and configured it. These were the softwares, some of the softwares we included in that operating system. Okay, let me see how the journey was started. Hussein KH, he's a member of SMC, and he created a lot of fonts, Regina, Mira, and lot of fonts. They created a lot of fonts. He was the man who came with the idea of moving to Unicode, not to open source technology. Basic idea was move to Unicode and XOC character set of old Libby. In this is another topic, I'm not digging into it. Actually, then almost every paper is using new Libby in Malayalam because due to the limitation of ASCII, they were using new Libby, but after Unicode came, it was very easy to include old Libby. So SMC's most fonts are in old Libby. So that was the first idea. Then they prepared for InDesign, but they couldn't afford it. That time, they heard that some other newspaper organization got fine from InDesign around 65 lakh. So they stopped the planning and they were about to stop the migration. At that time, Hussein and Ashok Mash contacted Praveen. He's a Debian developer and most active force guy in Kerala. He asked about Scribus, how Scribus, is it possible to convert to Scribus? And that time, Praveen contacted us and we created a team for migration. So this was a migration plan. Initial study, about 1 month. Then we know there are not that much ornament fonts are available for Malayalam. So he created three heading fonts for Janayugom. At that time, we went to the main office and sit with the main layout artist and prepared the first page of the paper in Scribus. But lot of people were rejecting. So they were used to PageMaker. They were very, the resistance was very big. At that time, we find some problems. We did some trials. There was a main problem was scaling width of characters. When we scale the character, we know in newspaper, if one sentence is not able to fit into a column, they will stretch it or so if we stretch the character, the character set got distorted. That was a bug of Scribus. Then I filed a bug in Scribus. Nearly in one day, less than in a day, they gave a patch and we applied it. It was working fine. So I stated earlier, the resistance from workers was a big problem in the earlier days. Okay, then the trial go for the next level. They created a special book, Onam special edition book, three editions. They created in Scribus, also Sunday special books. These three kinds of papers or books created with Scribus. That made confidence in them. After that, we gave training to the 75 employees. They were the layouting artists. There is no such sub-editors and layouts, etc. Each sub-editor is a layouter is there. So we gave near 100 employees training, including accountants. This was some pictures from the training session. We gave us 3 batches of 25 people. After that, we installed the GNU Linux system in each bureaus. After that, from October 2 to November, they completely switched their workflow to Scribus, Inkscape, Gimp, etc. And they didn't say to the crowd. After that, on November 1st, 2019, Kerala Chief Minister announced the official declaration of Janayugom uses so switched to completely open source software. This was feedback from Alapura sub-editor Sajid. Switching to Linux from Windows proved that all of the queries were meaningless. The shifting from PageMaker and InDesign to Scribus gave us new experiences. The use of Scribus made us sure that it will become world top publishing software. Using Gimp and Inkscape, well pages can be created in Scribus. The advent of new updates make us believe that the printing sector will seek dependence from Scribus, the free software. So that was hurdles we faced. First one was ASCII to Unicode conversion. Because they were using PageMaker for years. And lot of people still send them the documents as PageMaker files. In GNU Linux, there is no such a way to open PageMaker document without Wine. So we installed Wine and installed PageMaker, but that was so risk. So that was the first problem. They have to deal with PageMaker content, but we don't have PageMaker. So we created Janayugom Edit. And there was a libpagemaker package by LibreOffice. That is to open PageMaker document in Linux. We can open PageMaker document in Scribus, also in LibreOffice Draw. But there was an issue. If we open Malayalam content, most of the letters will be disappeared. So that was not a solution to us. But our team member Ambadi is digging into that code, and he found some encoding. There is one line, it's encode something, he deleted that, it's work fine. So he updated the libpagemaker, and that libpagemaker is included in Janayugom Edit. Now we can open PageMaker file in Janayugom Edit, open PageMaker and convert Unicode in simple step. So now they are converting each PageMaker document into Unicode in simple step. Then there was Scribus related issues, as I mentioned earlier. There was some crashes when we put hyphen in something, it was crashed. But the Scribus is fastly evolving one. That was fixed very easily. Then this is the main problem, Gimp. Gimp does not have CMYK support. For printing industry, CMYK is very needed one, but not a single package in Linux don't have CMYK support. So that still remains a problem, but Scribus has CMYK support. If we input RGB images, Scribus will produce CMYK images. So if we need more clarity or more color correction, we must need some CMYK support. That time we used reimage. Reimage is a Dolphin package. We can convert image to some sizes, etc. So we have Image Magic package. Using ImageMagick, we can use convert command. Using convert command, we can convert to CMYK. So we implemented that convert command into image. Then somehow that problem is solved now. Then some printers, you know, in Linux, some printers is very headache. So most of the printers were HP 120. We fixed almost everything. Then press. That was the most headache issue we faced ever. We sent the PDF to press. Sometimes they said the PDF is not taken by the machine. We want to open the PDF into InDesign, then make PDF again, then it will take. Not in the Scribus. Scribus PDF will not take in machine. The plate won't be made. There was two issues. One was they will put CMYK color dots in boundary. That was bit low. That was the one reason. Another reason was Windows XP. In Calicut, they were using XP machine to make plates from PDF. So in Scribus, if we create a PDF, the font will be embedded in the system. That embedded Unicode font is unable to used by Windows XP. So the program is crashed. That is the real situation. We found it during a lot of trial and error, and we connected through TeamViewer and etc. After all, we found that issue. After it, there is an option in Scribus to outline all fonts. That's solved every issues. Then networking. There was a Windows server. We in headquarters, there was 20 systems in layouting, and there was a one server of Windows. They were refused to update Windows server because the system admins were highly qualified in Windows. They don't know about Linux. So they refused. First time they refused to do everything, but after all, they changed their mind. Then we installed first time we installed dual boot, not completely wiped the Windows, we dual boot Linux. Then they said, not server. Okay. After, so then we connected server to Samba, but there were some issues, some lag, some problems. Then we can set up a Linux server. Okay. After it, we set up a Linux server, and using SSHFS, we connected that. Now everything is working fine. This is Media Self-Reliance Summit. After the inauguration, with the help of Kerala government and Kerala Press Academy, we conducted a seminar on media self-reliance and FOSS. This is the minister, and he will give some money to the open source contributions to the, sorry, he'll give money to the press media academy initiatives for the FOSS migrations for the other purpose. Okay, I will show you some demonstration. This is the Janayugom Linux. Okay. This is Scribus. If you don't know about Scribus, this is Scribus, and this is a one page done in that. Okay, I'm not going too deep. Yes.
One minute. Prepare for questions.
Yes.
Prepare your questions for a lot.
Yes, we also formed a new consortium, and other newspaper also contacted us, but they need a newsflow software. So we are in the plan to create a newsflow software with that producing the Scribus output. Unsolved issues is that CMYK support. Also, multi-threading. The Scribus doesn't have multi-threading support. That's because if we have a long book around 100 pages, the Scribus will hang. This is because of multi-threading support. If we fix these issues, we can absolutely, we can surely overcome the adobes. Okay.
Any questions?
Gimp pushes you to cross so many barriers to use free software. So we have talked with the government of Kerala a lot of times, multiple times. I've been at ICFOSS and talked about ERP Next, but there is nobody's interested in using ERP Next in Kerala. Now I realize why. It's too easy to use.
Yes.
Not a question. I just want to compliment you for two reasons. One is, typically when people, you have problems, you want to move to open source technologies using Windows, they have been in Windows, they move to Linux, when things don't work, right? You try using Wine, right? Things don't work, you actually pull back, go back to Windows, right? Now, I think you created a Linux operating system by yourself, of course from Debian, I guess, maybe, or Kubuntu.
Kubuntu.
Right, that's what you said, okay. And then you actually hacked it and gave patches and made things work. I think we should all give a big applause to him. Kudos to him. You could have actually gone back to Windows and ran your business comfortably. It's always possible. The fact that you went with this is really awesome. Thank you.
Thank you.
The Kubuntu fleet with something like Ubuntu Advantage, or is it just single standalone systems? How do you push updates on a consolidated basis? Are you doing something for that yet?
I didn't answer.
Are you managing, for example, there are MDM solutions for Ubuntu. Ubuntu runs Ubuntu Advantage, using which you can manage all the 100 workstations together. Are you doing something like that, or is it standalone?
No, just individual Ubuntu's. Yeah. Then we created an updater script using Zenity to update the templates and the fonts, etc.
Nice. Yeah. Did you get them off Tally as well?
Tally?
Yeah.
No, they weren't using Tally. Okay. They had their own solution of some using Codeigniter solution. That was an online solution. So we just have to tote LibreOffice.